Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, welcome to this video. We have a new build going on here. This is a Battle Mage class, and it is a build which is based around this skill, the Meteor Rain. And this is why I call it Meteorite build. Well, the idea of this build is to always be casting this skill, Meteorite, and kill as many enemies as possible by using this skill. And to do this, we use Warfare Mastery and Earth Mastery. And we have the Battle Mage class. So, when it comes to attribute points, I have spent almost equally points on Dexterity and Strength. On Strength, I have spent some more points. And I will keep spending points on Strength to increase the physical damage output of this skill, especially. Because as we can see, this skill maxed out at on plus 4, it deals up to 1672 physical damage. It also applies burn damage, but this doesn't really matter. It is a very small amount and it doesn't really get any big buffs from other items and skills other than this one, for example, or this one. And yeah, this one. So I'm going to be spending points of strength from here on, because this way we will increase the overall physical damage output of the build. Now, when it comes to skills, we have in Warfare Mastery maxed out this one because it provides attack speed. Offensive ability is useless for thrown weapon attacks, but the attack speed works pretty much fine. It increases attack speed with thrown weapons. We have maxed out this one, this one, this one. This helps greatly with this one, because when enemies are under the effect of the debuff, this debuff, minus percentage of physical resistance, then they receive even more damage from the meteor attack, the spell. And the meteor spell, I have seen numbers up to 16,000 plus, when enemies are under the effect of battle standard, which is a big amount, 16,000. Meteor Rain, very big amount. We have maxed out this skill. I will max out this one later. It is not that necessary. We have this one to get more attack speed and movement speed. And I have maxed out this one and this one. In Earth Mastery, we have maxed out all of these things. This physical damage here increases even more the damage of this one. And of course, when this one triggers, we deal much more physical damage and also fire and burn damage of this burn here. The burn damage, this one is fire burn, it is not electrical burn or frost burn, it is, when it says burn, it is only fire burn. We have spent only a single point on this one, a single point on this one, a single point on this one. You can see 5, 5 at 14 because I have plus 4 to all skills from items. And we have spent some points on this one, this one, this one, this one. My goal is to max out all these skills. I have also the pet to distract some enemies and help kill enemies faster. And I will max out these skills, and after I have maxed out these ones, I will come back here and I will activate this one and this one, sometimes when I attack with my thrown weapon, for this one to allow me to deal more damage at this one. The offensive ability of this one is useless for thrown weapons. Offensive ability works only with melee attacks, not with ranged attacks and spells. I don't think I will activate any of these ones here later. We will see. I don't know, but I don't think so. Now for the items. It is very critical for this build to have as much cooldown reduction to skills as possible. And this is why I'm using the Talisman of the Jade Emperor with minus 25% recharge. I'm using the Golden Shield of Pelerin with minus 18% recharge, and also energy cost reduction is super duper important here. And I am using this one with minus 36% recharge. Now, I have spent many points of dexterity, because as we can see, I have 499. I needed dexterity to be able to equip this item, which requires 454, this one, which requires 459. And this is why I spent points of dexterity. So, this one requires 420. I also have this one to reduce the energy cost for my spells, because I have only 781 energy points. And this skill requires 453 energy cost. So we use the skill and we see that we lose points, but we also have a great energy regeneration rate. The regeneration rate comes from this item, which provides plus 10 flat energy regen, this item, plus 10 flat energy regen. So having these two here, we get plus 20 energy regen per second, and we get some other buffs to energy regen from other sources, and we get up to 35.99 energy regen per second. Which is good enough. It is good enough for us to be able to cast all of the skills. Oops, wrong button. Let me show you. This one, we can see that, yeah, we lose nothing now because we have the battle standard active. Minus 50% energy cost. When you don't have battle standard active, you lose. And we can see this is what we lose. And until this one recharges, we have already refreshed totally our energy bar. So this combination of these two items is very critical for energy regen and energy cost reduction. We also have this item plus with all skills and some other good things for the build. We have this item, health points, strength, percentage, resistances, many resistances. And as we saw here, this one, which comes with Atlantis DLC, we have the skill slam, and we have the strength buffs, physical damage, which helps very much with the increased physical damage of meteor, right spell, and everything else, other attacks that deal physical damage. And we have the Apollo's Wheel, which is a great item. It helps, even the increased projectile speed helps, because we are using a thrown weapon, which is a ranged weapon. It releases projectiles. And here, of course, we have the Star of Elysium, which provides resistances and some physical damage, spirit damage, bleeding poison, and health regen per second. And these are offensive ability is perfect, but it is useless. It doesn't really work with this weapon. Defensive ability is not there. 800 legendary is approximately 800 is a very good amount of defensive ability for the whole legendary difficulty. At casting speed and movement speed, casting speed is not that important here. Movement speed, it is always nice to have as high movement speed as possible, but when we attack once with onslaught, we get this movement speed buff, and it is okay. And attack speed buff. So, these are the secondary resistances. This is the build. We also have the Aphrodite's Favor. Amazing item. The Chains of Might control doesn't work with spells. It works only with attacks of weapons. It's skills that use weapons to attack with. So it is not really a big problem, because for the most part we kill enemies with Meteor Strike and Slam and other things. This is the build. Let's go kill some enemies so that you can see some gameplay now. We have resistances. Resistances are very good in general, but some are not that good, so they are not perfect. Even my recharge reduction of skills is not perfect. It is 69%. I tried to reach 80%, but I couldn't. So, because this is the the items I had in my collection of items when I put together this build. And this is what we have. Of course, Meteor Rain is not the best spell in the game because it releases multiple projectiles, let's call them, but many times they miss the targets. The best time to use this spell is when you fight against many, too many enemies at the same time, so that you have increased chances for some of the meteors to hit enemies and kill them. ...16,000 damage. ...9,000. ...9,000. 15,000.
Think this is my home.
Deflected. That enemy deflected the meteor, which means the meteor didn't hit the enemy. The enemy avoided getting hit by the meteor. 10,000 damage. Almost 10,000, 14,000 one enemy. So we can see that even though the damage of the skill initially is 1672, with all the items and skills and attribute points we have spent on this build, invested on this build, usually we deal 8 times more damage. If not more. 9,400. Of course, this build is not going to be a very, very fast killing build because it relies heavily on meter rain, and meter rain has a recharge time, so we have to wait for meter rain to recharge back until we can use it again and hopefully hit many enemies. Someone was using disruptions, kill disruption on me. Oh, these meteors now hit all these skeletons. Okay.
Traveler, please, without this medicine.
Let's go there and see what will happen. Nothing hit the boss. No projectile. So, this is the build. It is very, very, very simple as a build to play with. But you need to find the right items to put the build together. And of course you have to be a bit patient because, as we can see, meteor rain spell is not the best in the game. Sometimes, in this case for example here, it worked pretty much perfectly fine. But in most cases it is very random and it doesn't hit many enemies. The good thing is that you can use meter rain also in caves, dungeons, interior areas like this one. Okay, someone would say so much for the realism of the game, but it doesn't matter, this is not, you know, a realistic type of a game. Okay, let's finish off the enemy with the thrown weapon attack. Let's turn back the amulet, the necklace.
The necklace! I wonder.
Okay, you got your necklace. The great thing is that since we have very good recharge reduction, we can keep casting the battle standard pretty much often. Very often. And this way at least we get from battle standard these things, the debuffs to enemies and also buffs to our character, especially 45% damage absorption. This helps very much with survivability because some of our resistances are not that good. So it can help very much. And oh, this one is dead. And yeah, even though sometimes we will have to run around and wait for meteor rain spell to recharge so that we can use it again, especially on big bosses, at least we can have battle standard down on the floor all the time, and this one will help with survivability. So I would say this build has good survivability, not the best maybe, but very good. If you use your skills at the right moments, then yes, survivability can be very good. Oh! This was a very nice hit. So, this is the build. This is a build which I wanted to make because I wanted to put together a build around Meteorite, Meteor Rain spell. And this is what I ended up with. Of course, if I had some other items in my collection, I could probably make this build even better, but I didn't. I had these items. I put together these items, and here we are. So guys, everybody, thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you have anything to say, leave a comment below. I'm coming back to live streaming tomorrow, actually. And I will have a big surprise for you all. So, I will see you tomorrow with my coming back live stream and a huge surprise I have for you. And everybody, thanks for watching again. And if you have any suggestions, questions about the build, leave a comment below, of course. I will see you very, very soon again. Have a good one.